In this problem, we're exploring the idea that the spin of the Earth can actually change your apparent weight. So this effect would be maximized at the equator. And we're given some numbers on this. So I have the radius of the Earth at the equator is about 6,378 kilometers. So there's the radius. And I'm told the sidereal period of the Earth's rotation is about 23 hours, 56 minutes. Now that word sidereal just means that this is the rotation of the Earth with respect to a distant reference frame. The length of our day is actually measured with how long it takes to get the sun back to the same position in the sky. And that's a little bit longer than one sidereal rotation of the Earth because we're revolving around the sun at the same time. So this is just a minor correction to the problem that makes it a little more accurate than saying 24 hours for the rotation. We're also asked to keep at least 4 significant digits for all the calculations because we're looking for a pretty minor effect. We start with some basic circular motion math. So in part A, I want the angular speed of the Earth's rotation in radians per second. And we have to start with a lot of unit issues on the period. So the period is 23 hours, 56 minutes, and I want that in seconds. So taking 23 hours and multiplying by 60 minutes per hour, that gives me 1,380 minutes plus the additional 56 minutes. And that gives me 1,436 minutes. I then need to convert that to seconds. So I'm going to multiply by a conversion factor. And I get 86,160 seconds. Then to get the angular speed omega, that's measured in radians per second, and one rotation is 2 pi radians. And this happens every 86,160 seconds. And this results in an angular speed of 7.292 times 10 to the negative 5th radians per second. Next, just to continue the sort of circular motion basics, I'm asked for the tangential speed at the equator. And now that I have the angular speed in radians per second, this is really quick, v equals r omega, but I would like to get that radius written in meters. So I'll do a quick unit conversion up here. R is 6,378 kilometers. To get meters, you just have to multiply by 1,000. And it's probably nice to write this in scientific notation. So 6.378 times 10 to the 6th meters. All right, so back to part B. I take my radius of 6.378 times 10 to the 6th meters, multiply by my angular speed of 7.292 times 10 to the negative 5th radians per second. Now, radians are actually unitless. It's still helpful to write them sometimes, but just know that you can disappear them whenever you like. So my surviving units here are meters per second, and I get 465.1 meters per second. And we're not actually going to use that later in the calculation, but it's a pretty cool number to be aware of. Now in part C, I want the centripetal acceleration for a person standing on the equator. So in the picture, we're kind of looking down on the Earth, actually from below the South Pole, the way I drew the rotation. So I can draw a person on the equator over here. And to be moving in this circular motion, they must be accelerating to the center of curvature. That's the centripetal acceleration. So the first formula we learned for this is v squared over r. But then we also learn it can be written as r omega squared. That's what I'm going to choose in this case. And my radius is 6.378 times 10 to the 6th meters. My angular speed, 7.292 times 10 to the negative 5th radians per second, and I need to square that. And again, radians are unitless, so I can see that I get units of meters per second squared. And I get a centripetal acceleration that's rather small, and I'm going to leave it in expanded form, but I'm still keeping 4 sig figs. So I get 0.03391 meters per second squared. Finally, in part D, I get to the real meat of the question. So I'm told that I have a person with a weight of 833 newtons. That means mg is 833 newtons. And they're standing on the equator. And I want to compute the normal force on this person. Now, if the Earth wasn't rotating, n would just be equal to mg. The whole point of this question is that n is a little bit smaller than mg because of the rotation of the Earth. So we want a clear force diagram. We want to clearly show the application of Newton's second law, and we're going to find the apparent weight of the person, which is slightly less than their actual weight. So there's mg pointing to the center of curvature, and I was told that that's 833 newtons. And then the normal force, that's the force of the ground pushing up on their feet. That's what I'm after. And I know that the weight has to be a little bigger than the normal force, so that the net force points to the center of curvature, and this explains how you can have an acceleration toward the center of curvature. So I can write down Newton's second law. So before I proceed, it looks like it would be nice to have a number on the actual mass of the person. So if I do a little side calculation on that, mg is 833 newtons, which means the mass of the person is 833 newtons divided by g, which is 9.8 meters per second squared. And this comes out to a nice round number of 85 kilograms. So when we analyze F net, we have to choose which direction is positive for the coordinate system. And I'm going to make toward the center of the Earth the positive direction, because that's the way the acceleration points. That means this 833 newtons counts as positive. The normal force takes a minus sign, and then my mass is 85 kilograms, and my centripetal acceleration, 0.033391 meters per second squared. So I smash the numbers and get a value of n, and it comes out to 830.1 newtons. So it's interesting to express this as a percentage. My weight is 833. My apparent weight, that's the normal force, that's how hard the ground pushes up on your feet, that's 830.1. And to express a percent reduction in your apparent weight, I would set it up like that, 833 minus 830.1 over 833. And it's about a 0.3% reduction in your apparent weight compared to standing on one of the poles. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.